वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट एलिमिनेशन रिएक्शन। यस्टरडे वी आर डिस्कस वन टू एलिमिनेशन रिएक्शन and its mechanism. So let us see last time we have seen elimination reaction and we have seen that depending upon bond breaking and bond forming the chemical reactions are classified into four type and one is a elimination reaction. And in elimination reaction we have seen their types 11 12 13 14 15 and 16 elimination reaction. We are discussing about 12 elimination reaction. In 12 elimination we are again discussing about beta elimination reaction. So what is it mean by 1-2 elimination reaction? There we have seen that suppose you are having a starting compound carbon carbon single bond, the valency of the carbon is a 4. Suppose here is a group called as a Y in general and here is a hydrogen. So this carbon is called as alpha carbon and this carbon is called as a beta carbon. In 1-2 elimination we have seen different type of one. We have seen E2 mechanism, then E1-CB mechanism, E1 mechanism and E1-CB mechanism. We have discussed already the mechanism of this reaction. We are discussing about E2 mechanism. In E2 mechanism we have seen that the bond breaking and bond forming process takes place simultaneously. So here base react with the substrate, here is the substrate and in reaction what happen, the bond between this carbon C alpha and Y break, the bond between the C beta and H also break and it will form a carbon carbon double bond between C alpha and C beta. At the same time this base abstract this proton. So in the first step, which is a slow step, RDS step, bond breaking and bond forming process takes place simultaneously. Here is a carbon and the bond between the alpha carbon and this Y group undergo breaking. The bond breaking and bond forming process, they are shown by the dotted line, alpha carbon and a beta carbon. At the same time the bond between the C beta and H also break. At the same time the bond between the base and this hydrogen undergo form. So this process takes place simultaneously. So there is a formation of a transition state. This is your transition state. This is slow step in which both base and substrate, they are involved in the reaction. And in the first step, the bond between C alpha and Y undergo complete breaking. This sigma bond shift here, formation of double bond. Here is the formation of a pi bond. And this sigma bond abstract this hydrogen. So there is a formation of corresponding carbon-carbon double bond between the C alpha and C beta. So there is a formation of alkene. And this base abstract proton. So there is a positive charge on the hydrogen. So base becomes positive and this B becomes positive. We have seen this is the general mechanism of this reaction. We have seen also the example of this reaction in which last time we have taken the R. Here, suppose if I take here CH3, here is H, here is H, and also here is H. And suppose this Y, maybe here chlorine, bromine, or iodine, means halogen. So there is a formation of corresponding transition state. Here is H, H, Y is, you can take chlorine, bromine, iodine. Here is also H. And further, there's a formation of a corresponding compound like this one, means alkene. We can take R, the remaining one, the H can be also replaced by the R. This R methyl group, maybe ethyl, maybe phenyl. So this is a simple mechanism of E2 mechanism. So bond breaking and bond forming process takes place simultaneously. So we have seen last time that the rate of reaction is directly proportional to the concentration of a substrate and that is a base. So this is the rate of reaction. We can remove the proportionality constant. So K2 substrate and base. So this is the E2 mechanism. Now we have explained the E2 mechanism. Here you find that the bond between C alpha and Y break. It is the first step. All the steps take place simultaneously. The bond between the C alpha and C beta pi bond form. And third process also takes place, the C beta and H also break. So all this process takes place simultaneously. So there's a formation of a transition state. Now we have to give the evidence for the mechanism. What is the evidence for the mechanism? So let us see the evidence for the mechanism. In evidence, we have to explain that all these three processes takes place simultaneously. So let us see the evidence for the mechanism. Evidence for E2 mechanism. In E2 mechanism, we have seen that all these three processes takes place simultaneously. Bond breaking and bond forming process takes place simultaneously. Here we have seen one important process. The bond between the carbon and hydrogen break in the RDS state. So one important evidence we can give, kinetic isotopic effect. In kinetic isotopic effect, we check whether the bond between the carbon hydrogen break or not. Right? If it break, then we can say that it obeys kinetic isotopic effect. So bond between the C alpha and H, if it break in the RDS step, then it obeys kinetic isotopic effect. It is also called as a primary kinetic isotopic effect. Now you have to let us see the example. Suppose same thing I will write. Here is the carbon, as we have taken in the general mechanism. Suppose there is a Br, and here is a pH benzene nucleus. Here is the H, all the remaining valency, we take H hydrogen. The reaction takes place in the presence of base, and base here we can take ethoxide or methoxide, or you can take also any base. ETO minus means, ET means ethyl, ethoxide. Ethoxide is a base. So in this case, what happened? Again, same thing, the bond between the C alpha and C beta. C alpha and C beta break. This sigma bond shift here, and this negative form a bond with the hydrogen. So this is the slow step, RDS step. We can consider the rate of reaction is KH, because all are the hydrogen. All are the hydrogen. So we take the KH is the rate of reaction. And we can write it's a direct product, or we can also write it's a mechanism. Here is a pH, here is a carbon, here is a H, here is also carbon, here is a H, right? So in this case, what happened? The bond between this carbon and hydrogen break. The bond between the C alpha and this Br also break. Bond breaking and bond forming process, they are shown by the dotted line. So as Br is more electronegative as compared to carbon, sigma bond will open here. So there is a breaking of a C alpha and a Br. As it will break, carbon C alpha becomes partial positive. We have to neutralize this partial positive. So this sigma bond break and it will shift here, and there is a formation of a such type of pi bond. So you get such type of a transition step. And further, in the first step, this sigma bond break completely, and there is a formation of Br minus. This sigma bond shift here, formation of a double bond, and there was a here ethoxide. Ethoxide also form a bond in the RDS step. So here the bond between this ethoxide or base undergo forming. So this is a transition state, and here you can get corresponding compound that is your alkene. pH, here is the carbon, here is the H, here is the carbon, here is the H, here is the H. In this case, there is no any change takes place in the skeleton, and there is a formation of a carbon-carbon double bond. So you can corresponding alkene. This alkene here is a, that is ethoxide, ETOH. So there's a formation of alkene. You'll find that here the bond between the C beta and H undergo breaking, means beta hydrogen undergo breaking. The bond between C beta and H, it undergo break. It is shown by the dotted line. And suppose if you find out its rate of reaction and we note down it as a KH. Now same thing we'll take and we'll see how this will if suppose if I take the same reaction and I replace all the hydrogen by the deuterium. So same reaction, all the hydrogen they are replaced by the deuterium. So pH, here is the carbon, here is the deuterium, here is the deuterium, here is also carbon. So all hydrogen they are replaced by the deuterium, and here is a again same thing, that is a Br. So in the previous case only we have replaced all the hydrogen by the deuterium. Again the reaction takes place in the presence of ATO minus ethoxide as a base. Again same thing, the in the substrate the sigma bond will open on the Br, Br negative and a C positive. Again this is shiftier, as carbon becomes positive we have to neutralize this positive sigma bond of double bond, and the bond between the C alpha carbon, the C beta carbon, the bond between C beta and undergo breaking. So D becomes partial positive, so it form a bond. So here in the there is a formation of transition state. It is a slow step, or D but it is a slow step. Here same thing, pH D, here is also D, here is also D, the bond between the C alpha and C beta. So this C alpha and Br undergo breaking, then the bond between the C beta and H, there is a D, undergo also breaking, and the bond between base ETO undergo forming. So this is the transition state. The highly unstable, highly energetic, so that's why it is called as a less stable, so it is a transition state. There is a formation of a pi bond, and further in the first step the bond between the C alpha and Br undergo complete breaking, the C beta and D undergo also complete breaking, and C alpha and C beta undergo complete forming, and you are getting corresponding product, that is pH, here is a C, here is a D, here is a carbon, here is a D, here is a D, and there is a formation of a pi bond. So you can get a deuterated alkene, right? So again the byproduct is ETOH. ETOH alcohol. Now here what you have done, we have replaced all the hydrogen by the deuterium. So here if you see the rate of reaction, take it as a KD, and experimentally it is observed that KH is not equal to KD. KH is equal to KD. It indicates that the bond between the carbon and hydrogen, it undergo breaking. So the bond between the carbon and hydrogen, it undergo breaking. And it is possible only in this case if there is a C beta and H. So in ETO mechanism, there is a breaking of a CH bond, breaking takes place. That's why KH is not equal to KD. Now question is, why KH is not equal to KD? Look here. In the transition state, you'll see that the bond between the C beta and H undergo breaking in the previous case. In this case, the bond between the C beta and D also undergo breaking. The CD bond is stronger than the CH. Here, the CD bond is stronger than the CH. So it requires more energy to break. So here, the rate of reaction is slower as compared to CH because it requires more energy. And CH can break very easily. So this can break very easily. So its rate is somewhat lower. KH and this KD, it requires more energy. So its rate is somewhat higher. That's why the KH is not equal to KD. So here, we can say that the CH bond breaking is involved in the RDS state, or simply we say that it obeys kinetic isotopic effect. It is also called as primary kinetic isotopic effect. So in this way, we have given the evidence for the mechanism, that is the E2 mechanism takes place with the breaking of C beta H bond. Now let us see the next evidence for the mechanism. If we see the mechanism, we will find that there is a breaking of a bond between the C alpha and X. Here X you have taken the Br. So this X may be fluorine, chlorine, bromine and iodine. So here the depending upon the nature of X, so we can say whether it will affect on the rate of reaction or not. So let us see the next is the nature of leaving group, because in this case the leaving group is X, and this X may be chlorine, chlorine, bromine or iodine. So let us see again example. In example here, what we'll do, we'll take this example in general. Here is R. In instead of pH, we have taken the R in general. Then there is a CS2. There is also CS2. And these are HH. And here is X. Here is a X. This alkyl halide, when treated with a base in general, it follow E2 mechanism. If it follow E2 mechanism, then here the sigma bond will shift here. We can write one of the hydrogen like this one. Let us see. Here is the H. This is your alpha carbon. And next one is the beta carbon atom. The carbon atom which is directly attached to the functional group is called as alpha carbon. And this is your beta carbon atom. So this will break here and this will shift here, and there is a formation of a corresponding alkene. Here you are getting alkene RCH double bond CH2 plus corresponding compound, that is a base, right? Now let us see, suppose B is a base, so you can get in general like this one. Now here what you'll do, we will replace this X by different group. So number one, suppose we're having R, here is a CH, I write only CS2. Suppose in the substrate we are having the X is your fluorine. So this is your substrate. Is alkaloid. Number two, we can replace all the halogen by fluorine, then chlorine. Number three, CS2, chlorine, chlorine, then bromine, and number four, that is iodine. So these are the example of halogen, fluorine, chlorine, bromine, and iodine. They are halogen family. Now here, we have seen the substrate. Now we have to see what is the rate of reaction. That is a relative rate. That is a relative rate. Relative E2 rate. So it is seen that if fluorine is there, if the rate is 1, then the rate of fluorine substrate will be 70. Then of bromine will be 4 × 10³. And for iodine, it is found to be 2.5 × 10 to the power 4. There's no need to remember this data. We can also write in general. So fluorine, how the rate, suppose if 1, then as compared to fluorine, the relative rate of E2 is 74 into 10 to the power 3, 2.5 into 10 to the power 4. So here you observe that as we move from fluorine to bromine, and bromine to iodine, the E2 rate get increase. E2 rate get increase. What it indicates? It indicates that here all the hydrogens, the beta hydrogens, they are the same. Only we put all the data same. Only where we change the hydrogen, fluorine, bromine, and iodine. So in this case, in the ABO mechanism, we have seen that the C beta H bond break at the same time C alpha X undergo breaking. If it break, then the rate also different. So here the rates are different. It indicates that the CX bond breaking takes place in the RDS step. And this effect is called as element effect, because we are going to change the element. So this effect is called as an element effect. So this is one of the evidence for the mechanism. In this way, we have seen that the C beta H C alpha X undergo break. So from this one, we have explained that the bond between C alpha X also break in the RDS state. It also break in the RDS state. So we have seen two process, that is C alpha X and C beta H undergo breaking, right? So this sequence also found same in the SN1 mechanism. Now here, look here, we have seen that the fluorine is having the more rate as compared to this iodine is having more rate as compared to fluorine. Then a question arises, why this iodine break very easily as compared to Br, as compared to C, as compared to fluorine? Means iodine is a good group as compared to Br. So this point we have learned already in the nucleic substitution reaction, that iodine is a good living group as compared to Br, as compared to Cl, as compared to fluorine. So what is the reason behind one? The good living group is a conjugate base of a strong acid. It is a conjugate base of a strong acid. So we have seen already also in this topic, what is a conjugate base, what is strong acid, and the conjugate base of a strong acid, they are the good living group. So if you see, the iodine is found to be a good living group as compared to Br, as compared to Ca, as compared to fluorine. So the living group ability will be like this one. Iodine is a good living group as compared to Br, as compared to Cl, as compared to fluorine, because iodine is a conjugate base of a strong acid. If you consider the acid, Hi is acid. This Hi is a stronger acid as compared to HBr, as compared to HCl, and as compared to, that is a HF. So here is a living group, and here is a acid, acidity or acid. These are the strong acid. So the conjugate base of a strong acid is a good living group. So there is a living group ability. That's why this Br undergo this carbon, the bond between the C alpha and X, that is the iodine, undergo breaking very easily. So it can break very easily, means the rate of reaction is also faster. So in this way, we have seen the that is E2 mechanism, two evidences. Next evidence, in this mechanism, that there is a presence of B C beta H bond, or there is a presence of a C beta hydrogen, and all the hydrogen or all the process takes place simultaneously, means bond breaking and bond forming process takes place simultaneously. Means if structure permit, there is no exchange of hydrogen exchange. So the next evidence for the mechanism we can give absence of hydrogen exchange. Absence of hydrogen exchange. In this case, we can take example. You know the two mechanism, E2 mechanism and E1CB mechanism. So in E2 mechanism, we have seen bond breaking, bond forming process takes place simultaneously. So there is no complete breaking. All process takes place simultaneously. And in E1CB mechanism, you will see that there is a formation of a corresponding carbanion. Suppose if you take such type of example, there is a pH, there is a CH, here is H, here is also CH2, and here is a Br. These are substrate 2-phenylethylbromide. It is a 2-phenylethylbromide. So this substrate, it is your alpha carbon, it is your beta carbon, or carbon number 1 and carbon number 2. At carbon number 2, there is a phenyl, so 2-phenyl. And 1 and 2 means ethane, ethyl chloride, ethyl bromide. This, when treated with a base, we can take here ETO minus. So in this case, what happened? First step is a fast step, it is a reversible step. So this can also convert into the substrate. So this is a reversible. And there is a formation of a corresponding carbanion. So this sigma bond will open on the carbon. This sigma bond open on the carbon. And this will abstract this hydrogen. So there is a formation of a corresponding carbanion. CH negative, here is a CH2, and here is a Br. So you can get corresponding carbanion, and this carbanion further with react, or it undergo elimination of Br, the bond between the C alpha and C Br break. It is a slow step, RDS step, and you can get here pH, CH, double bond, CH2. You get corresponding alkene, that is a phenylethene. Now look here, in this step we find that in the E1CB mechanism, so this follow by the E1CB mechanism. Here there is a formation of carbanion, but if it follow by the E2 mechanism, all this process takes place simultaneously. So there is no formation of a carbanion. There is no formation of carbanion. You can get directly this alkene. So if it follow E2 mechanism or even CB mechanism, we have to check. If it follow by the E1CB mechanism, there is a formation of carbanion. If it follow by the E2 mechanism, then it do not form carbanion. It form transition state and there is a formation of alkene. So what we'll do here, we take this reaction and we add deuterated ethyl alcohol. So instead of ETOH, we take a deuterated ethyl alcohol. So what happened? This sigma bond will open here. There's a formation of alkene if it followed by the E2 mechanism. this is your, that is alkene. But here, if there's a formation of carbon ion, then also there is a possibility that this negative will open, it abstract proton between this oxygen and deuterium, that is a D, and there is a formation of CH, and it is a CH2 and Br. So there is a formation of a such type of a material, and you can detect the presence of a deuterium. The presence of a corresponding alkyl halide, that is a deuterated alkyl halide, it indicates that the reaction follow E1CB mechanism, but not by the E2 mechanism. So if there is a absence of a hydrogen exchange, if there is an absence of a hydrogen exchange, then you can say that it follow by the E2 mechanism. If there is a hydrogen exchange, then you can say that it follow by the E1CB mechanism. So in the mechanism, if there is absence of a hydrogen exchange, then it followed by the E2 mechanism, because the bond breaking and bond forming process takes place simultaneously. And if there is a exchange of hydrogen, here what you have done, suppose if you take H means ethyl alcohol, so again there is a abstraction of a proton from the ethyl alcohol, and you can get corresponding to the starting compound. So here you can get the corresponding to phenyl ethyl bromide. But here what you have done, we have taken corresponding deuterated ethyl alcohol. So this carbon ion can abstract this deuterium from the deuterated ethyl alcohol, and there's a formation of corresponding deuterated alkyl halide. So formation of this compound, it may indicate that it followed by the E1CB mechanism, but not by the E2 mechanism. So we can say that if there is absence of hydrogen exchange, then it followed by the E2 mechanism. So these are the three evidences for the E2 mechanism. So what we have learned in this reaction, elimination reaction, 1-2 elimination reaction, it can be shown by the three mechanism, E2, E1, E1CB, we have learned already. The general mechanism, we are discussing about the E2 mechanism. This is your E2 mechanism. Bond breaking, bond forming process takes place simultaneously. Rate is directly proportional to the concentration of a substrate and base. And the three process, C alpha Y, C beta H break, and C alpha C beta pi bond formation takes place. So we have to give the evidence for the mechanism. So here, one evidence we have seen, that we have explained the kinetic isotopic effect. So this reaction, you'll see that the bond between the C beta and H undergo breaking. So here, as it obeys the kinetic isotopic effect, KH is not equal to KD. So you can see that the CH bond breaking in the mechanism. Nature of leaving group, we have replaced the hydrogen by the fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine. Iodine is a good leaving group. So here, the relative rate of iodide is more as compared to Br, as compared to chloride, as compared to fluoride. That's why the CX bond breaking is also involved in the reaction. Why iodine break very easily? Because it is a good leaving group. Because it is a conjugate base of a strong acid. Last point, we have the absence of a hydrogen exchange. If it followed by the E2 mechanism, there must be absence of a hydrogen exchange. But if you are getting deuterated that alkyl halide, it indicates that it followed by the E1CB mechanism. So these are the three evidences for the E2 mechanism. These are three evidences for the E2 mechanism. In this way, we have seen the E2 reaction and their mechanism and evidence for the mechanism. So there is a formation of a carbon-carbon double bond. and depending upon the nature of substrate, again there is an introduction of the carbon-carbon double bond that will see the orientation and the reactivity in E2 reaction. So in E2 we have seen one definition, second example, general representation, mechanism number one, it is a one-step process, bond breaking, bond forming process takes place simultaneously. Then kinetics, the rate of reaction directly proportional to the concentration of a substrate and base, so it is a second order reaction. And in evidence, you have taken three evidences. One evidence, it of kinetic isotopic effect. Number two, we have taken elemental effect. And number three, we have taken absence of hydrogen bonding, right? So in this way, we have seen the E2 reaction with that of your mechanism and evidences, right? So if you have any doubt, you may ask any question. Let us discuss. If you have any doubt, you can ask any question. Kanchan Singh, Rohit, Sakshi, Srikant, Srinka, Srusti, kuch hai doubt? Yes. If you have any doubt, you may ask. Sneha, Supriya Chaudhary, do you have any doubt?
No,
Supriya
sir.
Chaudhary. No, no doubt.
No, sir.
Are you getting? Okay, so I think if you don't have any doubt, right, then we should stop here. Thanks to all.
Thank you, sir.
And try to read at your home. I told you already that as soon as you learn in the class, on the same day, try to read those topics from your reference book, from your textbook. If you read once or twice, it becomes very easy to understand the concept in the next lecture. And if possible, when tomorrow you are coming for the lecture, try to again read once so that all the concept becomes clear. Everything depends upon each other. Everything depends upon each other. So thanks to all. You can leave class. And you can go further. Okay, Srishti Vishkarma, there are the 4 minutes. The third, I will share my screen again and will be clear. Look here, right? Srishti, are you getting here? Absence of hydrogen exchange, right? Absence of hydrogen exchange. We have seen that 1-2 elimination can be explained by the three mechanisms: one E1, second E2, and third E1CB mechanism. Right? If it followed by the E1CB mechanism, there must be formation of a carbanion. There must be formation of carbanion, and carbanion further it will shift here, and there is a formation of corresponding alkene. But if it followed by the E2 mechanism, then there must be formation of a corresponding transition state. The bond between the C alpha and Br undergo breaking. The bond between C alpha and H undergo also breaking. At the same time, the bond between base ETO and H undergo forming. So this is your transition state. At the same time, the bond between the C alpha and the C beta undergo formation, right? So here there is no comp- complete breaking of any bond. So there is no scope for the formation of carbon ion, and directly in the fast step, the slow step, if it follow by the E2 mechanism, it is your E2 mechanism, and here it is a E1C mechanism. So here this is shift here, this is shift here, and of course again you are getting the same compound pH CH double bond CH2. If it follow by the E2 mechanism, then you are getting this compound. But suppose if you carry out this reaction, and if you carry out in the presence of ETOD, if you carry out reaction in the presence of ETOD, there is no exchange of hydrogen with deuterium. Means you are not getting the deuterated alkyl halide in the E2 mechanism. In the E2 mechanism, there is no formation of deuterated, that is this compound. Here, if you follow by the E2 mechanism, but in this case, here, of course, you are getting alkene. You are getting alkene. Same compounds are there, but if you follow by the E1CB mechanism, you are also getting formation of a deuterated alkyne if you carry out reaction in the presence of ETOD, right? But if you follow by the E2 mechanism, there is no formation of such type of compound. You get only E2, that is a alkene. Formation of alkene only, it indicates that there is absence of a hydrogen exchange. There is absence of hydrogen exchange. So here in E2 mechanism, there must be absence of hydrogen exchange. Right? So this is the last mechanism. Srushti. समझ में आ गया आपको? Yes, right? Okay. So there are the three mechanism. If you know the three mechanism, E1, E2, and E1CB, the next part is very easy. As you all learn in the nucleophilic substitution reaction, there are the three mechanism: SN1, SN2, SNI, and depending upon that one, you have to follow the factors affecting on the that reaction. Okay. So I think we should stop here. Thanks to all, and you can leave meeting. Thanks. Thanks to all.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thanks to all. You can leave meeting. Yeah.